People like to compare business to chess. They like the analogy. Moves, counter moves, strategic thinking. Fact is, chess is nothing my business. In chess, you have rules, order. Business does not. With chess, each piece has its role, people take turns. But in my world, pawns have a habit of acting on their own. So what do we do when this happens? Well, I spent some time talking about business, so it's probably assumed that I would... But you'd be wrong. If I were to kill someone, they can't make me any money. So now perhaps you've moved on to thinking that I would...
Where is my money, Bill? Where is it?
But again, you'd be wrong. You see, this man is a public figure. He walks into his office with a face like mincemeat. There is a chance some people may become suspicious. So, what am I left with?
No!
You got very lucky. Very lucky. Are you listening? So the next time you and I have a deal, we stick to it. Yes? Fear is an incredible tool for cooperation. But you, mustn't let them know they're not in any real danger. It's the danger, you see, that creates the fear.
I don't understand why you're doing this. I don't understand, Bill.
Look, we had to make cutbacks, okay? Payments had to be made.
You're cutting half your workforce. There's no one left on the floor now. This is ridiculous. We're the ones that are making you money, Bill.
Look, I know it's hard, Phil, but we had to do it. Look, I'll write you a reference if you like. When and if you need it. But it doesn't have to be like this. I mean, you know, you'll be snapped up in a minute. You'll find something else. You're a smart lad. Something will come up, I'm sure. Phil, come on. Don't end it this way. You know, you've been good. Like I said,
there'll be... Go fuck yourself, Bill!
Thank you.
he just fired you?
Yeah. No warning, no reasons, just let go.
Well, that's fucked up.
You said the firm was in major debt or something.
Maybe he owes money to someone personally?
Yeah, maybe.
Sir.
Morning, Ernest.
Bill's payment has been made.
All right. Jesus, I knew the man was a coward, but I didn't think we'd scare him that much. Beautiful. Just beautiful. Let him know that he's paid up for the rest of the year. You'll need to remind Robert as well that Ellaby and Beale haven't made payments yet.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Of course.
Thank you. Hardly worth packing the bag.
Are we sure about this? I just don't feel up for it today.
Yes, we do. You'll be fine.
Like, I appreciate your dad getting me this interview and everything, but I just don't feel comfortable.
No, just relax. Alright, just smash it.
Do I look alright?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
He looks really serious. Does he look on his face?
I recognise him. Yeah, he was at Bill's firm the day before I got fired. Bill looked pretty shaken up by it. Hey! Hey!
Hey! I suppose you knew who that was.
No, probably no one.
Get a name for me, would you?
I'll put someone on it.
I thought I recognised him from somewhere. We saw earlier on.
Mm-hmm.
He's in all the pictures of Bill and Ellaby and all the local business owners, but he's only named in half.
Alright then, Sherlock, who is he?
He's some guy named Ernest Hunter.
Mm-hmm. What else?
Well, that's all I can find out about him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Weird. I think it's probably time he got some sleep.
Yeah, I guess. You can go up, I'll be up in a few minutes.
Alright, make sure you are.
Information you requested, sir.
About?
The man outside Ellaby's.
Well?
Phillip Shortland. A small-time accountant. Studied at Manchester University until he came home to work at Bill's, where he worked until he was laid off, because...
Yes, I'm aware of the reasons as to why, Eric. Don't assume that you can make me feel guilty.
Of course not, sir.
So, what does he do now?
Nothing. By all accounts, he's unemployed.
And how does he know me?
Sir?
Earlier today, when I was getting into the car, he recognised me. I could see it in his eyes.
I don't know, sir.
Well, then you're going to have to find out, aren't you, Eric?
Yes, of course.
All the things in this world that I hate, incompetency is at the forefront. As for you, Philip, I will be keeping an eye on you.
Afternoon.
Yep.
When you weren't in bed this morning, I figured that you'd gotten up early to look for work. Obviously, I was wrong.
Sorry, I was up all night researching.
It's fine. Just promise me that you'll drop this into guard.
I just want to find out who he is.
And now you do, so just move on.
No, I have no idea.
Well, why does it even matter?
Because he's the reason I'm out of a job.
So? What are you going to do when you actually find him there? Give him a stern talking to?
No, I...
Yeah, no, you didn't faint, did you?
As usual.
Look, I don't mean to sound like I'm having a go. I just think that your time's better spent looking for a job, for instance.
I know, but this is at the forefront of my mind, and I can't just look for a job without knowing what happened.
I know, I completely understand that, but please,
That's Robert. He's an old friend of mine. We go back a very long way, actually. I suppose you could say we're business associates.
Robert.
Hey.
Nice to see you again.
Nearly everyone's paid up for this quarter.
Nearly everyone. Nearly isn't enough, Robert.
No, it's not.
So? Who's the weak link?
Ellaby.
Ellaby? I thought it was Beale who hadn't paid this month.
Ellaby's been late on his last 5 payments. 3 of them have been less than we expected. This is Beale's first late payment, probably just following Ellaby's influence.
So, you think Ellaby's stepping out of line on purpose?
Whether he is or he isn't, he's making us look foolish. If we let him continue, others will follow suit.
All right. Well, it's fine. I'll see to it personally, right?
I'll send a letter to the partnership, informing them he's no longer an associate.
Now that is very good, Robert. Until I see you again.
Until next time.
Tonight?
I don't know. Money's a little bit tight at the minute.
Bill's still looking for a job?
Yeah, something like that.
Cara, what's wrong? Come on, Cara, you can tell me.
He just sits there, researching this Hunter guy. Stupid.
Who?
Ernest Hunter. He's this investment banker. Phil's got it into his head that he was the reason he got fired.
Sounds a bit paranoid to me.
I won't let him hear you say that. Won't take it well.
You guys aren't fighting, are you?
Yeah. It's been hard.
Kira.
It's like he's changed.
Come on, he'll be back on his feet in no time.
Yeah.
Okay?
We'll
Come
see.
On.
Hey, Bill.
Hi, Phil. Do you want that reference?
No. I just want to ask you one question.
Sure. What is it?
Who is Ernest Hunter? Bill.
I can't have this conversation, Phil.
But do you want me to meet you somewhere, or?
Hi, Phil.
Bill! Bill!
See you here. Why? Why are you here, Ellaby?
Because I fucked up.
A little louder.
Because I fucked up.
You did. You stopped paying. Why, Ellaby? Why?
Because I don't have any money. I haven't had the money.
You haven't had the money?
No. But, come on. Get me out of here, I can get your money and double. Double tomorrow. Triple the next day, come on.
Trust me, Ellaby. You're going to give me a lot more than money could. With these, you'll make amends.
Each one
is going to go to our own associates, and it's going to be a little gift from yourself. Alright. We'll start with maybe part of your ear, or maybe finger or two.
He can't. Throw it there.
What's this one? What does that say on me? You can read.
It says Bill.
It does. It's quite a big box, don't you think? Finger would be a waste.
Look, I can get money, I can get it away tomorrow. Just let me out. I've got people who've got money.
Enough, Ellaby!
Oh,
talk.
Hey, Bill, sorry I'm late. Why are we meeting here?
Shut up. I can't stay long. He doesn't know I'm here. Were you followed?
Why would I be followed?
Sleeping around after one of the wealthiest men in the area. Trust me, he knows you've been followed. Have you spoken to anyone else? Phil?
I haven't.
Good. Here.
What's this?
Just read it. I'll tell you everything that you need to know. You're a good enough accountant, you'll understand. You didn't get that from me.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah?
Thanks.
What for? It's never here.
Into everything that I've been saying.
Phil, I thought we talked about this. You were going to drop this.
No, I did. No, I was, but then Bill gave me this call and I couldn't say no. You know, this is proof, this is the evidence why I lost my job.
Phil, he may be the reason that you got fired, but you not having a job, that's on you. You're just so caught up in all this bullshit. Did he even take responsibility for your own life?
Bullshit.
Yes, bullshit.
No, you don't see. Yes. No, you don't see. This is legitimate evidence behind one of the biggest fraudsters in the country. This is, he connects all these businessmen together on this guise of a charity, okay?
Just drop it! It's driving me crazy. Please, just drop it.
I'm sorry, I have to do this.
Phil. I'm asking you. Please, come here, please. Just let us go. You can find a job somewhere else. You know who he is now, brilliant. But please, for me, I need you to let us go.
I can't.
What if it doesn't end here? What if there's someone else? After that, and after that, off your tinfoil fucking hat for 1 second!
What are you
saying? It's not your business!
Of course it's my business! This guy is the reason I don't have a job! He made it my fucking business card!
Phil, you need to... Let's go. Oh, I go.
Kira?
I will not work my arse off on every single day! Why don't you just sit here and just play conspiracy? Whole life! Do you even know how lonely I am? To the point, do you even care?
Kira, you're not even making sense anymore.
My things.
Where are you going?
I'm getting my things!
Kira.
Get out of here!
Fine. You're better off without you anyway. I can get to my genuine work in peace now.
Fuck you.
Sir, Phillip Shortland is here. Says he needs to see you.
Phillip?
Shall I send him away?
No, let him in.
Oh, actually, Eric, before you do, send him to one of the empty garages, please. I'll be out shortly.
Of course.
I suppose I should get some whiskey. I am a good host after all.
Good evening. I assume you're Phillip. I've heard quite a bit about you. Are you, you a drinking man? Right, just me then. Not much of a talker, are you?
I know about you. I know who you are, what you do, and I know about your associates as well.
Yes, it's fairly standard. You see, we're businessmen, Phil, like you used to be. What happened about that?
You've been scamming and threatening local businesses and hiding as some sort of charity.
Yes, well, you'd be right. You've caught me. But let me ask you, Philip. What can you do?
Go to the police. Tell them everything.
Mm-hmm. All right. I suppose you've proof.
I have this.
A notebook.
I got this from one of your clients who you've been threatening. Mm-hmm. This is proof that links you with everything. I've scanned this, and I have hundreds of copies of this ledger. I'll take them to the police, to Scotland Yard, to the Inland Revenue.
Unless...
What?
Okay. So, Philip, I'm going to do you somewhat of a favour here. I assume this is your first time. So, this is the part where you make your wild demands in order to keep this a secret between ourselves. So, what are they?
I just want my job back.
Well, that is disappointing. Nothing more than a job. You're an accountant, weren't you? 20k a year? For Christ's sake, man. This is anything and everything you could want.
Double, triple pay.
There we go. Well done, Philip. You're thinking outside. You're thinking of greater things. Moving on. This is the public conversation where I... Well, retort, really. Why? Why would a man of my position accept demands of someone in your position? You see, you realise that I'm rather far-reaching, and one of the perks of that is that I can make men such as yourself disappear.
If I disappear, the police will go to my house. They will find copies of this ledger. Any detective worth his salt will put two and two together and pin you. Okay, do you think I would come here without some sort of plan?
Think this was going to end. I agree to his petty demands, pat him on his back, send him on his way. Come now, you're smarter than that. You see, maybe you thought that good would ultimately triumph over evil. It's amicable, but naive. Philip here came unprepared. Simply put, unprepared good will never defeat meticulous evil. It's a shame, though. And I am sorry that this wasn't the ending that you wanted. What more can I say? Phil had so much going for him, and yet he was so overcome with obsession toward myself, he couldn't see all the things that were actually going for him. Still, it's no concern of mine, is it?
Yes, sir.
If could clean that for me, please.
Of course, sir.
Eric, when you finished, if you would be kind enough to send a thank you note to Bill, this ledger is proven to be quite invaluable, should we say.
I'll have someone sent right away.
Thank you. Life goes on.